I am so, so into this kind of Fauxbonichi journaling. I just cannot stop cutting out cute images and gluing them and making stuff in this journal. So I'll just continue in this video to use my collage sheets from Jennie Mae June. I made a video about her where I really gushed over all her cute images and how happy I am to have joined her Patreon to be able to just print any of the collage sheets she offers. It's such a treat to me. I then started a new journal with these painted papers. It's like a Fauxbonichi where I will be dating the days. So I've been working in it all through June, and today I'm making a voiceover just to share another video with you this week. So on this orange and blue page, I'm adding in a card that I printed from Jennie Mae, that I made into a journaling card. Then I added some washi tape, the only one I have with rainbows and unicorns. And then I'm playing with the texts that are like surrounding her images. So I really wanted to add that text that says, "Where will this door lead?" Because I'm excited about next month's adventures that I will be going on. And I feel like it's a new door that I'm opening. It's a new opportunity for me to try something. And even though I'm really nervous, I'm also excited. So that's what I've been thinking about. And the door with the clock head really said that to me. And it felt like it was something that needed to be going on this page. In any case, my name is iHanna, and I'm glad you clicked this video and wanted to watch it and maybe do some journaling along with me. I'm trying out a couple of new to me things on this page, and one of them is playing with these printable journaling cards with clouds. A yellow happy cloud and a blue sad cloud. And even though I couldn't really wrap my head around how they were configured, I was so sure before I cut them up that they were supposed to be glued to each other, but they are not reversed and does not fit, as you can see me trying to wrap my head around how to use them. And I was so sure that the front of the blue cloud would fit the blue backside with the journaling lines, but no, it was not flipped and it didn't, and then I couldn't understand how I could use this, so I left them for a while and went on to cut out some more stuff to use on the page. But not even planned, I just saw that the yellow cloud should really go on the blue page and the blue cloud should go on the orange page. So I'm happy about that placing at least. Then I was looking through what I've printed so far from the numbers and days. I did cut out a couple of different ones before I decided that I wanted this to be the 4th of June. So that's actually a Sunday, so I will find the Sunday later on and exchange it for the Monday, which I wanted to do something else on because I decided I wanted to print some photos from the Sunday. So then I'm adding more text to the back of this journaling card where it says dream spot. The journaling card is backed with a scrapbook paper, so I just used my glue stick and glued those two together because I wanted it to be a little bit stiffer. And then I'm adding in the Sunday and the 4th, the little rainbow that is so cute and that goes well with the washi tape that I was using as well. So I guess that's why I choose that tape to go. The orange page already has some red glitter that I probably added before I even bound the pages together. So I decided to shimmery up the blue page with a paper ribbon glued over the edge, which is something I really love doing. All since doing the colored glue book, where we did washi tape over the edge of all the pages in the notebook. I've done this before in earlier notebooks as well, but that was like the tipping point for me where I realized I love this and I want to do it on all the pages. So I've done it a lot more since. I'm showing you my cat food box that I collaged many years ago to make into a little container for small scrapbook paper pads. It's a perfect way to store papers, and it didn't cost anything extra because I used a box that was meant to go into the recycling bin. I picked out some origami papers, a blue for the blue cloud and a yellow for the back of the yellow cloud. There are lots of different colors in that pack, and they're super thin, so they're perfect to just be colors, almost like a tissue paper or a very thin paper that you can add anywhere without bulking up stuff. I decided I wanted to do back my both of the clouds since they didn't fit together retrospectively as I'm watching this, and even as I did finish the journal spread, I realized it was stupid, or at least unnecessary. I really like how it looked, but you will not see that paper very much in the way I add in the clouds later on, but I really love that they match so well, so probably I should have ripped pieces of the heart paper and glued it down behind the clouds instead, and that would have given the page a little more depth. But it's easy to see what you made wrong in after you've done it, or after you're finished, or to reconsider things that you have already glued down. And I'm not one to feel remorse and think a lot about, oh, I could have done this, I did it wrong, I should redo the page. It's an experiment and it worked out. Here's a close-up of how they looked when I'd cut them all out and finessed the edges. I was thinking about folding the little blue border and gluing that down to the page to make them kind of flip-ups. But I then found some like brads or whatever you want to call them. They're for hole-punched paper that you attach together with these. I don't know what they're called in English. But I had a little box that I thrifted, so they're like really like a vintage office supply that I wanted to use. And here I am trying to make a small hole in the cloud top. It was really difficult and I was struggling because that tool is for leather and it just did not want to go through. So I have to fiddle a lot. And probably I need a one hole punch thing in my next Amazon order or something like that, because that tool, I don't know, probably you could sharpen it or something, or it needs to be thrown out. It didn't even reach into the page, so I couldn't use it even though I tried. So in the end I just used a little scissor and made a little incision into the paper. It doesn't really matter because these brads are so big that they definitely covered the entire hole, and the legs of it are really big and chunky. But anyway, it's attached to the page and it's so cute. You can see the hearts, the yellow hearts, when you flip it to the side, and if you're looking from another angle, you'll definitely see them. We had no rain and almost no clouds in the beginning of June here in Sweden. So the reason I'm using these are not because it was very cloudy, but because Jen suggested that the sad cloud could be used as a journaling spot for something bad or sad, and the happy cloud could be used for positivity or happy thoughts. As you see that little saying that I will glue in as well, bad and sad, with an arrow pointing towards the cloud. So I want to do that, and I think it's a great idea to balance out the negativity with some happiness. The legs of that brand is covered by the fresh juice flip card that I've added already. That's also a video in case you want to take a look at my previous journaling video using this notebook and on that page what I did. It was posted last week, and now I'm just going to be gluing in some of the other bits. The text that I was just talking about. Then under the Sunday, I'm gluing in a little picture of a bird. He's a finch, and from the app Finch. It's a self-care pet, they're calling them. And you check in daily to say that you've done the things you wanted to do. You set your own goals, check them off, and when you do, a little Finch talks to you, gives you presents, and helps you find diamonds. And on the printable, it says, nourish the things that matter to you. That's as a little daily reminder. I wanted to print it and glue it into my journal because nourish is my word of the year. So that felt fitting. Then I'm rounding the corners of the actual journal, which I do afterwards in case I add in something to the edge. And I'll tape this card in later on when I've actually written something on the back. I will also be journaling on the backside of the clouds and on the actual page just a bit, because you can move the clouds aside and then you have lots of spots to journal on, even though it's painted with acrylic. I'm so happy how interactive and fun this page is. I really love all the different elements that I've used and experimented a bit more with something new to me. I think it works out really well, and even though you won't see these legs on the back, which I decide I'm going to be covering up with a piece of paper, let's say you are amazing that I got in Happy Mail, and I wanted to use it here just because those metallic legs were annoying me a bit, and I wanted to see how it looked glued down. You can still see them through the thin paper, but they aren't out of the way, and I have somewhere to start in my next journaling session. So, closing the book for today, wishing you a great creative day, and I hope to see you in my next video, which will be next week on Thursday. Thank you so much for watching. Take care!